The way you deal with ideas and day-to-day situations will largely depend upon your accumulated experiences. Generating a wider range of perspectives is seldom practiced. After all, you don't fix what you know works. But this tendency can make some problems seem incredibly daunting and a solution far too elusive. Creative thinking can help in this respect, but how? Hi, I'm Mike Lally of KnowYourMind.com. Though there are several styles of thinking, most of us tend to think reactively or passively about a situation. The brain directs our thinking according to our experiences. How we handled this situation before, and then we respond mechanically. Generally, this works well, but not for tackling uncertainty. Habitual thinking, whether it's reactive or passive, is unlikely to lead to a breakthrough. To move to a new level requires a quantum leap in thinking. Now, you've already experienced this before. The task is to make the skill more readily available. To elegantly discover the best solution to a problem requires having the freedom to think in different styles, taking the opportunity to use your creative powers. Now, most problems do not require anything other than a reactive or a passive response. But when you're faced with something really challenging, something that's difficult, it is an advantage to be able to use different thinking styles and select the most appropriate style and pattern for the given problem, and to be able to do so with confidence. One of the challenges when faced with a problem of a certain dimension is to avoid thinking too quickly in terms of how the solution will be applied. In other words, the brain is several steps ahead and pushes the thinking towards implementing the solution without even considering any viable alternative. In essence, it is useful to be adept at exploring and analyzing a situation before deciding the best way forward, and to be able to do this immediately and intuitively. And this avoids later regretting your actions. A drawback to proactive creative thinking is that it does take time to learn. It does require practice. It's not the conventional approach to problem solving. In other words, we rarely bother. I mean, why should you when generally there's no need? It does take time and requires plenty of practice to get into the habit of thinking creatively. Now, cause and effect also plays a hand. A given situation will cause the brain to quickly engage the way you normally respond to a situation. It happens spontaneously, but fails the creativity test. The task is to be aware of how your brain responds to a challenge. It's common practice for the brain to jump to conclusions far too quickly. We've been unconsciously programmed and we respond to a situation spontaneously, really quickly. It happens real fast, and it's based on our accumulated experiences. If cause and effect is dropped, thinking becomes more abstract and less persuasive. However, the payoff by analyzing future possibilities can not only change and transform, it can transcend the current situation. So developing the thinking to think in terms of contingencies will allow you to explore possibilities, and it can even give you fresh new ideas that can totally change and alter the way you think about any situation that may regularly occur, and particularly when you're faced with something significantly uncertain. Being in the habit of generating new ideas using creative, proactive thinking has an enormous payoff. And simply put, breakthroughs require creative thinking. Thinking passively or reactively does not provide a robust pathway. The results can be unpredictable, yet worthwhile, and occasionally breathtaking and illuminating. You'll be able to connect, create, invent, apply, test, rearrange, adapt, combine all kinds of ideas and reverse to get the solution, the best solution, particularly when you're faced with something significant that does require creative thinking and you have difficulty because you haven't practiced this style of thinking. That completes this part. Thanks for watching. Go to knowyourmind.com and let me know where I can send you something I believe will be of benefit to you. Remember, you have many faces, many skills, many talents, and some wonderful attributes So why not put them to use? Why not really tap into your creative power? So until we chat again, take care. Cheerio for now.